Please rise for the bride. Be seated. Dear family and friends of Ramon and Marites, we're gathered here in the presence of the Lord to celebrate the reaffirmation of their union in marriage. They present themselves joyfully and lovingly before God and before all you as witnesses that their covenant may be heard and consecrated. The candle now lit on the altar is in honor and memory of Agrippina, the bride's mother. And we also acknowledge and honor Tomas, the bride's father, and Donatila, the groom's mother, who are watching from the Philippines now. They're all present with us in spirit. I now invite the beloved family priest, Father Elmer, to come and read for us.
Brothers and sisters, we gathered here to join Marites and Ramon as they thank the Lord for the 25 years of God's faithfulness in their lives. And we ask God's blessing on this celebration as we are reminded from the Holy Book, from the letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 1, first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 13, 4 to 7 and 13. And St. Paul says, love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. And now, these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of this is love.
True marriage love is a union of souls and a bonding of minds, creating a connection in the heart and in the body. Its everlasting joys are interdependence, peace, tranquility, inmost friendship, unreserved trust, and a mutual desire of mind and heart to be of every possible service to each other. This joy has become even more beautiful as you have shared your mutual concern, care, and love. Marites and Ramon, as you have already discovered, your marriage relationship offers the highest and most intimate experience of love. Your growing bonds of affection, loyalty, and trust have brought you into a fuller life than either of you may have achieved alone. The very nature of this love is to want to give to another ever more fully and to feel the joy of your partner as your own joy. This love has brought forth the best qualities in each of you and has enabled you to overcome barriers and hardships, allowing you to share your life together even more deeply. As you stand here in this moment, know that love, loyalty, and trust continue to be the foundations of a lasting and happy marriage. And as you continue to fulfill your marriage commitment, may your life together be increasingly full of joy and peace. Ramon, in light of this vision of marriage, will you renew your commitment to Marites? And in your life together, will you continue to be loving and caring as long as you both shall live? If so, please say, I will.
I do.
Marites, in light of this vision of marriage, will you renew your commitment to Ramon? And in your life together, will you continue to be loving and caring as long as you both shall live? If so, please respond, I will. I invite you to share your renewal of your vows. Please repeat after me first, Ramon. I, Ramon, reaffirm my commitment to you, Marites.
Reaffirm my commitment to you, Marites.
As your husband. To share with you. All that is to come. And in all of our life together. I will treasure our love. Marites, please repeat after me.
I, Marites,
reaffirm my commitment to you, Ramon.
Reaffirm my commitment to you.
As your wife.
To share with you all that is to come.
And in all our life together,
I will treasure our love.
Ramon and Marites have also written personal vows to each other.
From the mountain of San Fernando, Bukidnon in the Philippines, we were neighbors. We were classmates in elementary and high school who became friends and then best of friends. We moved from Bukidnon to Manila to Los Angeles. Our relationship had been tested by time and circumstances. We faced every challenge bravely together, and I know we can overcome everything because God is our guide. And now we're here to celebrate our 25th wedding anniversary. We're grateful to have been blessed with three beautiful and amazing daughters. I promise you that I love you yesterday, today, and I will love you forever.
I supposed to make my own vow, but I think it's better for me to say it impromptu. Marites is the perfect wife. I cannot make this one without her. She's the best.
These rings are an outward and visible sign of your union. As the circle of these rings is unending, May your love remain strong and true throughout your lives. May the quality of your marriage deepen as these rings grow in beauty and in honor with their wearing. May they be symbols and constant reminders of the love that you share and the promises you have made.
In receiving this ring, the symbol of our love,
I reaffirm my commitment to you. As my husband. Now and forever. In receiving this ring. That would be you.
In receiving this ring.
The symbol of our love.
I reaffirm my commitment to you.
As my wife.
Now and forever.
The promises you have made to one another represent the spiritual connection that unites you two and sustains your marriage. So now I invite you to symbolize your union and your commitment and continuing intention to one another by coming to the altar and lighting your marriage candle.
Gihangyo na ko ang nadinhi to extend their hand as we bless the couple. Please stand. I will do the prayer in the vernacular because people are watching us in the Philippines. Ginoo, imong gihiusa si Marites ug si Ramon sa kaminyuon nga nagsalamin sa imong pagkamapinanggaon ug pagkamaluluyon. Daghang pagsulay nga ilang nasinati. Daghang bagyo ang ilang naagian, apan nagpabilin sila nga lig-on ug nagabarog tungod sa imong gugma nga walay kinutuban. Sa iyang pagbago sa ilang panaad, 25 ka tuig na ang niagi. Ipadayon pagbubo kanila ang imong nagabaha-baha nga mga grasya ug panalangin. Ayaw tuguti Ginoo nga madaog sila sa mga tentasyon. Himua silang makanunayon nga mahigugmaon nga mga ginikanan sa ilang mga anak nga si Yvonne, si Alexa ug si Erica. May the faithfulness of Ramon and Marited inspire their daughters to be faithful to the chosen life that they will embrace in the future. And may your faithfulness, Ramon and Marites, will always inspire couples to be faithful to one another because God is faithful to you. And may God's abundant blessings be upon you now and forever, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And may the Lord who joined you together 25 years ago and made it possible for you to renew your vows continue to bless you all the days of your life. May it free you from all worries and anxieties. And may God, who is faithful to you, continue to embrace you, to cuddle you, and to carry you in moments of darkness and difficulties. And may God, who has called you together, continue to inspire you and inspire more people to love and honor their vows together. And may God's abundant blessing be upon you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Marites and Ramon, in the presence of God and your family and friends, you have celebrated your reaffirmation of marriage. You have shared your commitment to each other and symbolized this by giving and receiving rings. It is now my privilege to pronounce that you have reaffirmed your covenant of marriage. As your marriage commitment is now reaffirmed, I invite you to seal your renewed covenant with a kiss. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Pasina. Let us continue to rejoice with them.
I'm going to start with Lourdes, Pasina, and Sir Manio. Next one is Mr. and Mrs. Galarpe. And we call on Mr. and Mrs. Repolio. Next one, Mr. and Mrs. Magapan. Next one is Mr. and Mrs. Kabunasa. Followed by Mr. and Mrs. Nagayo. Mr. and Mrs. Osiris. Next one is Yellow Chat Jessica. And of course, at the Union and Kids. Alright, next one, the Bridal Entrance. Bridesmaids and groomsmen, Jerica, Pasina, and Andre. Okay, come on. I request everybody to stand and let's welcome the bride and groom.
Yeah. to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, the first wedding dance of the bride and groom.
Thank you for everyone, especially the one who flew from the Philippines, Father Elmer, our Catholic priest. We're proud for him coming in. Also my sister who coming from New York, who flew here only for this purpose. And my cousin, our cousin who came from Florida only for this purpose, Nangbiki from Florida, okay? And for you guys that gave us your time to celebrate with us, also of course our direct family, I would say, Maribeth, who took off being the big time in Sunnyside, and Bubit, okay, who's a full-time RNMD, okay. Juan's parents are here, and she, both have like a parents of Juan, our extended family, of course, with Juan. Ryan's family also here, who helped us all the way, and I'm so grateful for you guys, and of course, the Bisaya group of Carson, okay. And the office of Dr. Davudian, represented by Mitsan, is here. Okay, don't worry, I will not call in on Monday. I'll be reporting on Monday. No honeymoon, no more. Simhot na lang. And the parents of our, the elaga of my wife, can you imagine like these two big boys here and the girl over there? For all Marites Alaga when they were like probably months old. And now look at them right now, okay? So we're proud of them. And Liam here, look at this Liam, okay? He's so tall. He used to be the Alaga of Marites and now he's so tall, okay? He's taller than me. And these two kids as well. At the same time, all other kids that Marites took care, can you imagine? I cannot imagine, like with her patience and everything, I cannot handle it. It's hers, okay? It's her patience, it's her, what? Did I miss anybody? I'm so sorry, I have to ask apology if I forgot to mention your name. That means in our heart, you're always in our minds and heart, okay? Of course, our children, Yvonne, who took off, I know that she's working hard for years delay, and she took off just to be here, and I know she took like so much labor for the cake, because this one, the only difference with this one, the first wedding that we had, I only planned it for 4 days. Okay, the first wedding we both planned for four days because at that time it's not properly planned because we have to go back to Manila and we have to flew to Mindanao to be married, and the only witness at the time is Maribeth, the sister of Marites. Okay, she's the lone witness during our wedding. At that time, to tell you straight, our wedding ring was only 25 pesos. Okay, and Okay? And now I would say there's some more improvement, okay? Now the 4 days plan of our first wedding, now we plan it 4 weeks. Okay? This, whatever you see, if in case it's not perfect, because we plan only for 4 weeks, and this is what happened, okay? Now, if we plan it ahead of time, maybe it's better, okay? All right, and then what else? She wants to speak because she says you talk too much. Okay, what else? By the way, Juan and Ryan, we're so proud of you to be part of our family, and hopefully you will take care of our children, because believe me, if they are not, they are right now, they are fully, I would say, not just vaccinated, but they're fully trained, okay? That means that they're true to their mother, because the mother stays at home, the behavior of the mother is the one they gets. Now, if they're not, like, if in case that you need some assistance, go to the mother, okay? And believe me, if there's something wrong, bring it back to us and we'll accept them wholeheartedly, okay? What else? What else? What else? What else? What else? Okay. Now, I'm not drunk. Okay? This is how I speak. Okay. And for the photographer, I would say Miss Rowena, thank you very much. And as always, the one that they did, that one is only planned in 2 weeks. 2 to 3 weeks. Okay? And this hotel was only planned 2 weeks also. Okay? The Mayfair was only planned for 3 weeks. So 3 weeks, 2 weeks, and 2 weeks, I would say. And this whole thing was planned in less than a month. Okay, so if you have the guts, if you have the will, everything, anything can be done. And God's grace, everything's planned. Our Father Elmer flew in less than a month. He flew from Philippines to here. Okay, also from New York, from Florida, everything's been planned for 4 weeks. Okay, and again, thank you for everyone who came here today. Photographers so knowledgeable. The DJ, I'm so glad that they were able to call me back in probably like I would say like a week or something. I would say yes, as you said, 7 days, still 1 week. What else? If I miss your name, again, I'm so glad also for our, the food, I would say it's gonna be starting probably at 1 o'clock, we're gonna start it. And I know it's, even Yvonne is the one who played for who prepared our cake, because we called every cake preparer, they cannot, they need like 2 months before they can make the cake. So that's why our daughter, we're so proud of her. Whatever is the outlook of our cake, that's her talent, because no one wants to accept our order for cake unless it's 2 months, okay? So she's the one. Whatever you see, that's the labor of Yvonne, okay? I'm so proud of her. And I told them, oh, it's Christmas Day. I don't want any gifts from you guys. I just want you to cooperate. I just want this one to be done for you, Mom.
Kung di pa mo gutom, tindog kay mga jita. Pero kung gutom na mo, ay na lang. Please stand for the prayer. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Gracious and loving God, we acknowledge you as the source of every blessing. We join in thanking you for the gift of faithfulness that you have given to Ramon and Marites. It is through them that you gather us all to celebrate life and faithfulness. And we thank you for the food that you have prepared for us, and we ask you to bless this food. And all of us will partake from this table. And as we eat from this sumptuous meal that you prepared for us, we ask you to bless the cook, the waiters, and all of us. And we pray for those who are hungry. Please also provide for them, so that all of us will look up to you and smile and say, yes, indeed, our God is a loving and provident God. And bless us, O Lord, and this thy gifts, which we are about to receive from your goodness, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Pakals na.
Hold everyone's excitement over the food that we are about to share. We are here only for one reason, and that is to celebrate with Marites and June. So let me have Rosaldo Nagyo and Maribeth to usher us into the toast to prepare us all to celebrate and join everyone in the meal. Bobby?
Paano ta? Toss up. Okay, let us rise. Let us put this, you know what is this thing? So, this is for Ramon and Marites. Congratulations on your 25th wedding anniversary. And yes, congratulations. Cheers! Cheers! Cheers!
Cheers to the 50th!
Thank you, Bobet and Beth.
Sugar. Oh, honey, honey. You are my candy girl, and you got me wanting you. Honey, oh, sugar, sugar.
Earlier, we already have introduced him, but I want to call on him again to give us a piece of his wisdom. And I want everyone to put their hands together to help me welcome Father Elmer Empinado.
Sa tinuod lang, ay magan ko naraba sila. Espanol, in Espanol. Yo hablo Espanol poquito. The truth is, I was expecting that this celebration will not push through because they only told me, Father, you come on the 31st of December. So I said, are you sure? Yes, Father, we'll book your ticket tonight. So that's how they prepare this celebrate wedding anniversary. But anyway, you know what? If you love one another, every opportunity is a perfect opportunity. Because nothing happened by chance. Nothing happened by chance. It is according to God's own time and plan. You believe in that? Even the booking of the chapel, according to their own time and date, is given to them because God intended it to be. So we are here not by chance, but it is because of God's own mysterious design. Because we meet people not by chance. We meet people because that person, persons, or peoples, or families, di mo ka-afford ng bacteria siguro. From the very beginning, they have a mission to do, and we have a mission to do in their lives. And thank you for allowing your home to be a home for many, a home for friends, a home for the homeless, a home for the friendless. And thank you very much for allowing us to enter into your hearts. And we are indeed privileged to be here to celebrate with you this silver wedding anniversary. Actually, in my small bag, I put the tarnished silver rosary that I got 28 years ago. I intended to bring it with me and show to them. Because although it is already tarnished, but the value of the silver still remains the same. In fact, as the silver lives longer, the value goes up. Kay ingon nila, ati gulang nawa na ilami. No, that's not true. Kung ano ba'y lami? Lami pa ba? Hindi mo na mo akong ipasabot. The longer the wine, it tastes better. That's important. So, this is our prayer, that the longer you stay together as couple, you will grow together, you will be much better couple. God did not promise you that there will be no typhoon, but remember, God will be with you in all the storms in your life. That is very important. And this is true not only to them, but to all of us. In fact, it is in the storm that we will know whether our relationship is really anchored on God. Diba? Randy, magkapatnood ka, anak? Ha? Ha? Oh, testigo, naupaw na kong ka sa kamatuuran. So that is why we are here. We are here to celebrate with you and to pray with you and to thank God. And we wish you many, many more years. Buhi pa man siguro ko 25 years from now. Mag-silver, mag-golden jubilee pa ta. Kanya iplano na June mga 6 months ha? Ay na nang 1 month. Ha? Oh. So, in behalf sa talan nga na adinhi, we wish you all the best. And then, ayaw kabalaka, you train your daughter so beautifully. Nakuha nila ang pasensya ni Marites. Huwag nakuha nila ang kabright ni Ramon. Ang bulsa, wako kabalo, asa nakuha kang Ramon ba or kay Marites ba? What is important is that you are good parents. Congratulations, you train them well. And then, hopefully, ang ilang umaabot nga mga bana, gi-welcome na nimo si Juan o si Ryan, murag tinuod na gina, no? So Juan and Ryan, you are already welcome in the family. If you want to be married in the church, the priest is available. Just send me a ticket and I will fly, okay? Congratulations.
Thank you, Father Elmer. Those were really very well said. Another important person, equally important as all the other siblings, is one who flew all the way from New York. Please help me welcome Lourdes Pasina.
Congratulations.
One word, but it says it all. Congratulations means a lot. A warm welcome again and applause for Lourdes. Congratulations now means she loves you both. A very talented brother-in-law has prepared this segment. If June and Tess prepared their wedding 4 weeks, Bobit has prepared this a year ago. Help me welcome Bobit Nagyo.
The song that I'm going to sing, I think it's fitted for our second time wedding, for our friend Ramon. And the title of the song is called Woman.
My mate's emotion and my toothlessness. After all, I'm forever and you're dead. And woman, I will try to express my inner feelings and thankfulness for showing me the meaning of success. understand that it's done inside of this man. And woman, hope you close to your heart. However distance, don't keep us apart. After all, it is written in the stars.
Come on guys, sing together.
Well, well, do 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 do, ooh. Well, well, do 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 do. Woman, please, please, let me explain. I never meant to cause you sorrow and pain. Please me tell you again and again and again. I love you. Yeah, yeah. Now and forever. I love you. Yeah, yeah. Now and forever.
Thank you guys, thank you. Congratulations.
Hi, everybody. Sorry, nagdala ko copy kay Limpanon man. Kanilig si edad, kasunod-sunod bitaw. Bisod kayo. Okay, all I can say is these two lovely couples, overflow and joy never ends. Am I right? Yes. Okay. Akong tubuson ako isuon kay dami siya nagingon kay ko paghimo ikaw kay di ko. Okay. With family and friends, of course, surrounded with them. And never tired of sharing their blessings from here to Philippines. And di sila makalimot, nilingigid sila sa likod. Kinsa tong nakatabang, higid sila makalimot. Anytime they have open arms to share about, to share with, also their three siblings. We are so lucky to have you guys. Thank you. My message to my brother Ramon Tibay Pasina and my sister-in-law Sisi Marites Concha Pasina. Okay. Two souls have completed 25th years of your love. You know, they are perfect combination and witness with their lovely three daughter, Yvonne, Alexa, and Erica. Thank you to have you guys. Kung baga buhing kamatuoran, akong gi kuan gi sumpay sumpay ang Bisaya kay di man ko makalimot ni Father Sumbilan. Okay, and then 25 years of attraction. Yes, of course, huh? Okay, 25 years of happiness, of course. And then 25 years of faith to God. Yes, of course, indeed. Okay. And now it's time to celebrate your silver jubilee. Oh, 25 years. Okay, have an amazing 25th anniversary. Wishing you to continue happiness and great success. And your family and with the siblings and friends. May God continue to shower all blessings on you and both forever. Sorry. You nervous naman ko good. Sorry ha. Understand, peace. Okay. From all of us, love and shine bright on your 25th anniversary. We love you always. And thank you guys for coming to celebrate their wedding anniversary, Jubilee anniversary. Thank you. Help me welcome, please, Maribeth Nagyo, the younger sister of Marites.
Kulban. Thank you for having me. I'm not ready to give this speech, okay? But anyway, congratulations to my sister Marites and Junjun. I would like to maybe say two things here. First is, I would say marriage is designed by God. Perfectly imperfect, because there is no marriage, it's not perfect, but it depends on
how you manage your marriage. Okay, go on.
And abinisayon. And also, second is your marriage, you experience a lot of trials and
triumph.
But you continue to keep your faith and love to each other. And I would also say that so as you have said, like you know your success in your life, and would say that, like as you also said, always like pangmayaman, but it's not complete your success and your happiness. And on your 25th, I would say that the greatest blessings is the reconciliation, especially to your loved ones, and forgiveness and peace. So I can say that you partially, or I hope completely, you know, you already know that, but you know, that's the greatest gift that you reached to your 25th. And congratulations. Yay! And I think Katura.
Thank you, Beth. Let it go, Beth.
June and Tess, we have known June and Tess for more than a decade, and this couple is truly a picture of success. Success not just inside their home, but also outside their home. And I'm sure June agrees with me that no matter where his life and career takes him, no matter how many times he gets promoted, he changes jobs, he changes boss, he only has one boss, and that's none other than Marites.
Wow.
The two of you and your family.
She flew all the way from Florida. And I know even if we haven't really been very close to her, we have heard fun stories about Vicky.
First, I just want to congratulate both of you and thank you for inviting me. Tess and I, we grew up together and I can remember all the childhood memories, so many of them. But then I moved to the US and we lost track of each other. I think it's been how many years? More than 30 years before we got together again, and I was so happy when it's been over more than 10 years before I haven't seen her, and then the first time we saw each other, they met me at the airport, and we all cried, the three of us, and it's like, oh my gosh, after all more than 30 years, and finally, after that we met, and then we got together again. We came back for Alexa's, her pageant. And after that, it's been like, we just communicated, and, you know, I'm so happy for what they have accomplished in life and the family that they've brought up together. I'm so proud of them, and then very, very happy of their fortune and their everything that they have. And I only wish that they could continue and have that 25 years will be more than that, 50 years. I hope to be here for your 50 years. And congratulations, and thank you again for being here and for inviting me to be here. And to everybody, join me in congratulating them and wishing them the best of life with the God's blessing. Thank you so much.
Hello, good afternoon. Hi, guys. Good afternoon, everybody. My wife is accompanying me because, you know, like 3 years from now, it will be our 25th birthday. So at least I told her that I need the cash back to the $2,200 a month for that occasion. You know, cashback, you know what's cashback. Okay. Akong resulte kay Ramon ug kang Marites sa akong pagsudong sa ilang katahom ug kaanyag karong adlaw. Akong nabaliklan tao ang mga their travel, no? Their travel to success. I'm not saying that they're fully successful because some kids are still going to school, but at this point of their wedding and their 25th wedding anniversary, I would say, and all of us would agree, that they're already successful, you know? So, I wonder also why Ramon and Marites, you know, there's a saying that happy wife, happy life. I found a translation from the internet. It says like, a wife in Bisaya is asawa. So there is a meaning for that. They said that, ayaw sopaka aron walay away. So that's asawa. So yeah, that's the meaning. So that's why I found it that, you know, sometimes as couple, I think this, you drop something there to make more you beautiful. Look at that lipstick right there on the floor. Yeah, right there. Lipstick. And then, so, as I said, that maybe, you know, when we are quite obedient with our wife, it seems like, you know, we must be like successful. And as you know what, Ramon is always outside the house. You know, he has been working and he met a lot of people, beautiful, like that, and everybody. Yeah, but because Ramon, he's a bana, he's a husband. And bana, I found it also in the internet, there's a meaning for bana. Bisan asa ka, naay asawa. So that's what make them, you know, successful in their marriage. See? Asawa, don't get quarrel with your wife. So that no trouble. Okay? And that the bana in English, it says like that, wherever you go, there is always a wife. So, makita na ko sa ilang anong ngana, why they are, you know, they are quite successful in their marriage. It's normal for us that we quarrel and then after that we go to bed. you know, so I'm so happy for them. This, John, ha? Padayon good mo sa inyo paginugog maay sa usa. In fact, according to them, di ba, they're neighbors, you know. So, actually, they are already blessed because it says in the Bible that you love your own neighbor. So, that what happened. They are neighbors, so they're loving each other. They have children. So, they're successful. They follow the will of God. So, John, this, congratulations sa inyo hang 25th wedding anniversary, ha? Okay, you're welcome. So, God bless you guys. Okay, salamat kaayo.
Thank you so much, Beth and Bobet. Help me welcome, please, Yvonne Pasina.
I have a little bit of stage fright, so they're here for moral support. All right, well, okay. Whew, my heart's beating out of my chest. Okay. Actually, I'm just going to speak to you guys, to my parents, because I feel like it'll get rid of the noise. happy 25th anniversary, Mom and Dad. Trivia fact, actually, I'm turning 25 years old this year as well. Yeah. And then their anniversary is in January, right? But my birthday, fun fact, is February. So that probably means I'm like 2 months premature, right? When I was born. Who knows? I don't know. Maybe it was a miscalculation on my birthday. I just exposed them. But I just want to say congratulations again. Not a lot of people know, or don't realize that your first definition of love really comes from your parents. So you envision it the way that, you know, they love each other, and all your values are just set and guided by how they, you know, how they go from day from day with each other. sorry. I just really want to say, like, thank you for providing, like, a really, really good life for my sisters and I. I know that life was really hard back in the Philippines. Like immigrant parents really had to do, like, a really, really big jump just to move from, like, a place of comfortability into, like, a new country that they don't really know. So, like, thank you for going through that struggle for us. And for providing a life for me and my sister. We're really, really, sorry. we're really, really grateful. And sorry. So yeah, just thank you for everything. I don't know if you guys just should really know that we appreciate everything you do, and we recognize how hard you work for us. And this life is just, like, perfect the way it is. There's no need for you to, like doubt it, because we're really, really grateful. Thank you. I love you. I love you too. We love you too. Take this mic away from you before I cry more.
Happy anniversary. Are we leaving?
Okay, so I guess it's my turn. I'm also just gonna talk. Yeah, it's your turn. So mom and dad, you guys have taught me a lot in life, being patient with each other and with people around me. I know that when I was a kid, and still now, I'm kind of hard-headed. And you know, sometimes I have a hot head, and I think I get that from dad. So, but with the love you guys share with each other, you teach me to be patient with those around you, and just be a good role model for Erica and Ati sometimes. but yeah, thank you guys for being great parents. You guys teach me a lot about working hard and taking care of my loved ones. And I love you guys a lot, and thank you for everything you've given me and Erica and Ati. I love you guys too.
I didn't know I was gonna speak. She said we were up here for moral support, so I thought the goal was just like a pat, but you know. Hi! Happy anniversary! You know. Give me like a minute. Like. You know, don't laugh. You know, you're my parents. Yeah, and I'm your daughter. And you know, sometimes we're family, and. And sometimes, sometimes we don't act like it. And sometimes, I'm trying to be sentimental. Let me get my sentence out. Okay, we're family. Okay, I love you. And even when we fight sometimes, we still love each other, and you still love each other. So, happy 25th anniversary! Woo!
Thank you, Erica. Thank you, Yvonne. Thank you, Alexa. You know, hearing the daughter speak leave us doubtless why June and Tess stayed married all these years. 25 years and counting, and we hope we will still be around on their 50th. June and Tess. Are we ready for the questions, June and Tess? Okay, number one. When you guys met, who made the first move? Okay, it's June. Number two.
Raise
higher so we would know, okay? So it was June who made the first move. Second question. Who had the bigger crush on the other? Wow. June had a bigger crush than Tess. Okay. Okay. Who decides where to go on dates? Oh. Okay. This time, it seems we know already who's the boss. Number four. I hope you won't find this offensive. Who farts more? Another one. Who farts louder? Okay, next one. Who is better at keeping secrets? Okay, now we know who to go to. Everyone, we know who to tell our secrets to, never to June. Next. Who goes to sleep first? Okay, June snores. Who's the bigger baby when they are sick? When he or she is sick? Who is the bigger baby when he is sick? Who wants more care and love? June. Okay. He's the only nurse who needs to be nursed. Next. Who's most likely to wake up grumpy? Oh boy, June. Who is always right? Okay. Oh, that's nice. First test raised both. And so that means that both takes the shot in their home. Next. Who is more stubborn? June. Okay, next. Now let's see who has the shorter attention span. Oh boy. Okay, now this one. This should take us back to 25 years ago or more than 25 years ago. Who said I love you first? Wow. No wonder he admits that he has the bigger crush on Tess. Next, who is more romantic? Okay, we don't doubt that, June. You choreographed all this, you planned all this, even that fine, tiny detail, you did this. Very romantic. Okay, next, who is the better dancer?
Oh, shoot.
Oh. Okay, this one. Now this one. Who spends more time on Facebook? Okay, we'll not wonder. Okay, this is just for fun. Who has a crazier family? No offense, man, just for fun. Who has a crazier family? What? Okay, I know we have young adults here. I might just skip this one if this seems offensive. Let me let go of this one.
You can say it in Tagalog.
Okay, no, I'll say it just the same. Pretend you don't hear it. Now that you have renewed your vows after 25 years, Who is most likely to say, not tonight, dear, not tonight? Okay, okay, now this one, let's see. When going around, who is most likely to get lost? Or in direction, okay. Okay, now another intimate question. Who is the first to apologize after an argument? Wow, okay. Be ready to toss the bouquet. One, two, three. Songbird who's gonna serenade. Is it gonna be a love song, Nikki?
Yes.
Oh, it will be. Let me please welcome our next performer. Today she is a full-time performer. Tomorrow and the rest of the days, she'll be a full-time student. Help me welcome the most talented daughter, the only daughter of our business tycoon friend, Roberto and Angie Galarpe. Nikki Galarpe!
I'm not afraid to die.
guys for dancing. Thank you so much.
Jerusalem,
thank you. so beautiful, and I tell her every day. Yeah, I know, when I compliment her, she won't believe me. And it's so sad to think that she don't see what I see. But every time she asks me, do I look okay, I say, when I see your face, day in.